So can you tell me a little bit about Susie and your relationship with Susie?
Well, Susie, her and I got on really well. You know, she got on good with me and I got on good with her, but she was terrific to me. Couldn't have been better. Last time I remember was she came down to see me and we were having a talk there and she was looking forward to her 40th birthday, which wasn't far away, you know. She was looking forward to that and I said, oh, well, that'd be good because I hope to get over there, which is a long way for me.
Your family did suffer some really tragic events. Can you just
Yeah,
run
that
through
was
that?
very tragic. That they was went up to Bensdale to stay with my mother, you know, for the weekend. And they went out that night and they met up with their cousin and he said, at Waiyang Hotel, and he said, oh, look, he said, I'll come back to my place, he said, we'll have a cuppa. So they went with him and he went the back road, of course, going home because he'd been drinking. And the Clifton Creek, which is normally just a trickle there, happened to be in flood at the time. Of course, he went straight through the bridge rail and into the creek. I lost my son and two daughters, and Susie got out. You know, her and another passenger got out. They were the only ones that did, and the driver, their cousin, he drowned too.
Susie went missing in 2002. Can you tell me about how life's been for you since?
Oh, it's been terrible, you know, since because it's been on my mind all the time, day and night. You never get over it. And it just wears you down, something terrible. And I can't sort of, you know, it's hard to get over it, really. I don't think you ever would. It doesn't feel like that long ago, that's for sure. It's just never goes. And it's getting worse, I think, as I'm getting older and crooker. It's not helping the situation. All my health has deteriorated. For a start off, had a heart attack. I had to go to Melbourne and get a stent put in because, from the heart attack. And then with the examination they done down there, they found out that I had a tumour on my lung, which causes lung cancer. And now I'm here at the hospital getting treatment for that every day.
People do have knowledge of what's happened to Susie. What would be your message to them on coming forward and providing information?
Well, I reckon there's definitely somebody out there knows. Look, there's more than one person knows what's going on. I'm certain of that in my own mind, and I only wish that they'd please help us and come forward because, and like I said, a mother and a sister and me. Well, it's just killing us, really. It's terrible.
What would it mean to you if we were able to bring this to an end, you know, and find out what happened?
Oh, it'd be terrific, really, to bring it to an end. At least it'd be some closure, you know, which definitely needs something. And somebody, please help.